Hello,
It shouldn't.
everyone. Welcome to the predictions for Survivor Series as well as a review of Raw, SmackDown, and NXT.
NXT. I would try to remember what happened at NXT. It wasn't that much good matches. I know the Ascension came out of NXT and went against Gable and Jason Jordan. I believe Jason Jordan then won.
First match I'm gonna do is Kevin Owens versus Neville.
That's BS. Yes, Summer Rae! Summer Rae, distract him! There we go! My boy! My boy, Tyler Breeze! Come on, Tyler Breeze.
Anyway, my opinion, but Kevin Owens versus Neville match was pretty good. I mean, Kevin Owens never really has a bad match.
Never has.
And Neville's not that bad.
I just feel like they ain't doing nothing with him.
Yeah, I feel like Neville's kind of getting that Evan Bourne thing going.
The Evan Bourne feel. Beauty shot. I feel like they just
Oh
gonna have.
shit.
I mean, if I think he goes to be a champion, I think the only highest he'll probably be is the United States Tag Team Intercontinental Champion. I don't. As of now, probably if he ever does anything spectacular to, interest the WWE, that like turns him to be like, oh, we see him as a World Heavyweight Champion. But until then, I think that's the only thing he gonna be. Kind of like Ryback. I don't think Ryback is gonna become the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. When he first came in, they was
Yeah.
trying to make him, trying to push him very hard.
There's a lot of hype for that.
That's what they, that's the thing, they
But
pushed him too
yeah,
much and
they overhyped.
shoved it down our
It
throats.
was
Yeah,
overhyped.
that's what happened.
That's what we're doing with Roman Reigns now. Like, I
That's
feel like
psychic
Roman
Roman
Reigns is being
Reigns.
pushed too much.
Yo, I'm telling you, every SmackDown is Dean Ambrose or Roman Reigns wins every match on SmackDown. Like, they haven't lost one match on SmackDown. They never have. I didn't even finish watch the end of the SmackDown match with Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose together taking on Alberto Del Rio and was it Kevin Owens, I
Yeah,
believe?
it was Kevin
I
Owens.
didn't watch that because I know who's gonna win. They win every time. It's Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose gonna win. I don't know how they won, but I know they're gonna win. That's why I didn't take time to watch it.
And
Win
there's the
all the
match.
time.
This one-on-one battle is underway, and you can cut the tension with a
All
knife.
the time.
Many
Oh,
fans still believe there's no better way to
since
settle the
everybody thinks
score
I'm
than
playing
to
on
be
easy
beginning in
mode,
that
because that match was
ring
too easy, let me
and
go to my
fighting.
settings and I'm gonna show y'all where my
No way,
game
nice reversal.
balances.
Nobody home
Put my
there.
balances up like
Nobody home.
this.
Cole, that looked like
You know what
that
I'm
house
saying?
had
Make
been
it
empty
kind
for
of more
months.
challenging. And what is it, gameplay? On
Kevin
legendary.
Owens,
Oh
let's get
wow,
your
I had
take on it.
Iron Man
You're
matches up to
talking about
25
someone who
minutes.
has
I'm pulling
all the
30.
talent necessary to become one of the So in that
all-time
Kevin Owens and
greats.
Neville match, of course, Kevin Owens won with a pump-up powerbomb. But it was out of nowhere. I mean, usually
That was a
he
wild strike.
throws
You're
his
talking
opponents
about
against the
Raw.
ropes.
Target.
Yeah, it looked like it was
Yeah,
completely
I'm
out of
talking about Raw.
desperation. I'm about to jump into SmackDown after Raw, though. Anyway, that was a first
SmackDown.
match of Raw.
You have to respect that
What
Kevin Owens
was
knows
the
what he
second? wants
I
and
can't
goes
see. I
right
can't
after it. He's
remember
one of the
everything in
most
order.
undercard
I can just
competitors
remember
we've seen in a long
the
time.
main
I'm not so
highlights.
sure
Not
Sami
trying
Zayn
to say Raw
respects
is
that. Kevin Owens
boring,
wanted
but
Zayn's
it do
NXT
have some
title
stuff in
and cut
there.
to
What
the
the
front
that
line
3 hour
February 2015
event kind of makes you
defending.
like, damn, like you just
What are
can't
you
sit
doing
there and
here? What's
watch
he gonna
the
do
same
here?
stuff for 3 hours. Like you just want to change it. Well, I know Randall knows more about what
I
happened
think we may be
because I
eating some
watch
too
every
much.
stuff while I'm watching Monday Night Raw.
Oh, out
Unless
of
he brings something
nowhere.
else and I remember what
Very
happened.
nicely
The
done.
second
match was Tyler Breeze versus R-Truth.
Kevin Owens shows us some clever offense
Okay,
here.
yeah, I remember that now. I remember that.
Talk
And
didn't
we'll get
Tyler
in the
Breeze
reach.
lose?
No, Tyler Breeze hit.
You'd have to think that Kevin Owens' brawling style
Tyler
makes it
Breeze didn't
incredibly
lose.
difficult to game plan for.
I don't really remember. Oh yeah.
That's why I got quiet. I don't remember what happened.
All I know is that Tyler Breeze won.
Hold up. I'm gonna bring up the match stuff. I'm gonna go on the YouTube channel. I'm gonna bring it up there. Yo, I can't remember, dog. It's too much. It's too much wrestling.
Tyler Breeze won with a beauty shot. And that's about it. It wasn't too good of a match because they put Tyler Breeze up against a jobber, basically.
That's what it did today on SmackDown with Zack Ryder.
What I liked about I'm gonna jump into that match later, but one thing that I liked about that is that Tyler Breeze used Christian's finisher.
Did?
Yeah, the Unprettier.
Prettier? Is that gonna be his new signature move now? It's like 10 matches.
And I just lost this match. I'm gonna do a rematch on this. I pressed a pin button way too quickly. Like, you know how you do that kick out shit? I pressed that way too quickly. And look at the impact in these
highlights. That's one thing about this friggin' game, man. That kick out meter. I mean, it is easy when you get the hang of it, though. I'm not even gonna, like, flex and BS on it. Hold on, I'm going through the roll right now. Okay, I got it. To kick off was the Brother Destruction. I remember that. When it came out. But no, we passed that. Now we on. It was Tyler Breeze. R-Truth. We already knew. We just went through this. We already knew who was gonna win that. I mean, and plus, they said that was Tyler Breeze's debut match on Raw. So I mean, you ain't gonna make him lose his debut. I mean, let's just be real here. And after that, it was Ziggler versus Dean Ambrose, which I think it was a great match, in my opinion. It was a lot of resiliency in that match. The only way for personal issues to be ultimately resolved
is two superstars enter the squared circle and go one-on-one in a good. But as far as the whole heavyweight world championship tournament goes, we all know it's going to be Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose in the final. Let's just clear the air right there.
I just can't wait to see, like, what is going to happen. If I mean, yeah, we know that already. We know that. But just, like, who is they going to be friendly? Do you think he's going to be a heel? And if he's going to be a heel, who would you want to see who will become the biggest heel?
On SmackDown, they said they weren't going to let it come between them. But we all know that it's going to come between them somehow.
They need a new poster boy while Seth Rollins in bed, rebuilding, redesigning, and getting healthier. What are you trying to do?
And playing video games with Xavier Woods.
They need some flavor to it because, if you notice, once he got injured, like it draws and Smack. I mean, SmackDown's always been dead, but, you know. Like, it's for the last couple of weeks, 2 weeks, Raw's been dry. You know, Seth Rollins always put their flavor into it with the little laughs. But he puts the flavor into it. So now, since he's gone, now it's basically dry. So they need something big, you know what I'm saying, to, like, really pop off. So right now, everybody's still thinking about Seth Rollins. Like, he's been gone for 6 months, ACL and MCL, he said, his tour. So they need something big. I personally think Dean Ambrose is going to turn heel, but I'll be very surprised if Roman Reigns turns heel.
Yeah, because of that segment that he had with Triple H a couple weeks back.
Yes. In real life, I would have took it.
Yeah.
I would have took it.
Who wouldn't know?
Oh, I got a comment. Hold on, let me see. Tournament, WWE Rubberweight Championship now. You want me to do that? I could try to do it. I mean, as right now, I'm just playing, like, universe mode. Just getting the feeling. Well, since you're here, pretty sure you watch wrestling. What do you think is going to happen on Sunday, Survivor Series? Who do you think is going to win that championship? I'm not focusing.
Yeah, that's what happened to me. I wasn't focusing, and that's why I lost so easily. But now I'm more focused.
You ain't gonna get me with that. I got no reversing slides. I gotta rebuild. Like, I'm Randy Orton. I'm going against Heath Slater. Anyway, where is Heath Slater at, man? I like this dude, man. I miss him, man. He's funny.
Yeah, he's been off TV for a while. I think they might release him.
I hope not. They did it to Drew McIntyre and Jinder Mahal. Or she call it Jinder Mahal. Like what I used to call him. I know I say his name. Jinder Mahal.
Anyway, the third match on Raw was Dolph Ziggler versus Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose won. Really nothing much to that match. It was a well-organized match, though.
It looked like they had chemistry. The ending of it, we, like I said, we already knew who was going to win. But yeah, that was a. And then after that, it was a New Day. The New Day came out. Hey, oh God, they steal the show every time.
Yeah, they do.
They steal the show every time. It's nothing with. They could do anything. Like I said a couple days ago, it's like they could just get a script and look at the creators like, I don't need this BS, man. I got you. And then just surprise them. And by just talking.
He's been through hell and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack. And I hope we can get a doctor out here.
Damn.
Damage ribs. Yeah, so the match after that was a New Day versus Ryback and the Usos.
It sure was. Now that match, I can't talk because I didn't really watch it. So you could talk about that.
I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if that ended up being the 5-on-5 Survivor Series match. But I'd like to see who we're going to... Well, we're probably going to add... I don't know. I'd say they'd probably add Sin Cara and Kalisto to that match. But I don't know who...
Do you think it's gonna be like any surprise, like guests that's gonna be there? Might take some slots open. Surprise wrestlers that nobody would think that would be there as a tag team. No, I can't even think of one. That's why I'm actually.
Surprise? No, I don't think so.
I can't really think of no surprise superstars. There we go. Yeah. But you never know.
Never know.
From time to time. Yeah, and guys like Kevin Owens aren't usually the ones you see doing a senton. What happened after that? I believe the Usos won that match, right?
I'm almost I'm 90% sure about the Usos and Ryback won that match.
I believe they did. Then after that, you had Triple H, talks to Cesaro. I think that was Cesaro's easiest scene he ever did in the wrestling business. He just sat there and listened to Triple H talk. He didn't even say, yeah. He just smiling in his face. Smiling in his face. That was easy for him, but... Like I was telling, Flail Pack couple, you know what I'm saying, before I'm not offline. I feel like Cesaro, and I'll correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel like he's going to be the champion in the future.
Yes.
If he continues doing what he's doing.
And
but every time.
You finish first.
All right, so every time when, he gets that push, they always end up putting him as a tag team, kind of what they did with Tyson Kidd. No bad knowing Tyson Kidd, but. They always put him on a tag team or they're pushing him down the drain. It's like, y'all begging for him to get the brass ring, but he's kind of there. But like I said, they don't want to give it to him yet. They want to focus more on Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins now. So You know what I'm saying? That's what they want to do now. Probably after when they become champion, or Dean Ambrose, Roman Reigns, champion, they might pass it off from them to other wrestlers down the line. Like Cesaro, I can't think right now, but yeah, Cesaro and others that played a big part.
Anybody would trust anybody in this industry. Everybody's trying to get to the top covers.
And as far as that match with Roman Reigns went, it was, yeah, that was also a good match. But could have been better.
Must be serious injuries. No kidding. This is gonna need some.
Who did he fight again on Monday?
Roman Reigns and Cesaro.
Cesaro. Now I'm not gonna lie. I knew who was gonna win, but I had times where I was changing about my mind. The Cesaro was doing great, but that was their plan. They wanted him to look strong in the match. Did you know how they always want Roman Reigns to look strong in every match? But they turned the table. They made Cesaro look strong just because they didn't want to make him look weak. He lost to Roman Reigns, you know what I'm saying? So I think they did, like, a good job with that.
You have to respect that Kevin Owens knows what he wants and goes right after it. He's one of the most no-nonsense competitors we've seen in a long time.
The ending was good. The ending of that match was good. Oh my god, he's going for Roman Reigns. Get the frick off me. Oh my Jesus, Lanta. You can't.
Neville's always reversing. Hold up, let me check my comment section quickly. Because I don't have a shit open. And pardon my swearing. Okay, Gabrielle Rico said WWE tournament. Yes, the tournament for the World Heavyweight Championship. We all know that the two people at the end are probably most likely going to be Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose. But as far as it goes,
that's the same dude who commented online.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Roman Reigns is going to win, and then Dean Ambrose is going to turn heel, is my prediction, but it could also play out the other way.
I will be very surprised if Roman Reigns turns heel. Like, that would be,
I'd be happy.
Amazing. I want to see him as a, I think he could be a better heel than what he is now. And his face, it looks like he gets much pressure. I'll be surprised if he becomes the man. You know what I'm saying? And Triple H, and then when Seth Rollins comes back, Seth Rollins become a face, and basically that. Imagine Seth Rollins is a face though. But that would be good because you know how you try to think about all this rebuilding his character and all this stuff. So it's kind of making sure he's on the positive side of things. So maybe if he do turn back, he might be a face. But when he enters back, them fans are gonna go crazy, man. I'm telling you. That's like how CM Punk was when the night in Money in the Bank. That's how it's gonna be.
Yeah.
I can already see it now.
Now, the fifth match of the evening was the Ascension versus the Dudley Boys. Really wasn't that good of a match. But actually, that could work, though. Like, if they put the Ascension on the Usos team, and then, I mean, on the Dudley's team, I mean, fuck, on the New Day's team. Yeah, I fucked up a lot there. And then the Dudley Boys on the Usos team, that could work out.
Yeah. I feel like the Dudley Boys should get a big part in Survivor Series. I mean, this is... They did put a lot of work in back in them days. But I don't know. I wish the Dudley Boys would become the champion. Before the Usos. Before the Usos.
And it looks to me like our winner is already thinking about the next match.
He was doing that.
And then the Dudley Boys on the Usos team.
Pedigree.
Bam.
Bam. Bam. Bam.
See, in that rematch, I won. Because I was focused that time.
Yeah, I'm focused right now. Roman Reigns, you better not kick out. Yes, because he ain't had no resiliency.
Kalisto versus Alberto Del Rio was a poorly worked match. It's like
very poor.
It's like Alberto Del Rio doesn't know how to wrestle luchadors, even though he should be able to.
I like him. He could wrestle. I like him. I like him. But that match was just something that you could tell that they wanted to do that match. You could tell like they didn't have like no charisma in that match or they didn't drive. But I don't get it because they both Mexican Spanish, so they should know how to do it. But who knows? You can't like sometimes you just can't find the right person. I'm pretty sure WWE won't do that again. They won't do that again, though. Put those two in the ring together. Unless it's a tag team match or something like that.
Okay, the next match I'm going to jump into. Well, I'm going to jump into that contract signing for a little bit, and then we're going to move on to the next show for this week in wrestling. At contract signing. A lot of people didn't like it. I thought it was great. Paige got under the skin of Charlotte. And then what happened after was nice. Paige really doesn't do anything wrong, though.
But that's what Paige do. Like, Paige got that look like she just don't give two shits about nothing.
I mean, a lot of people think she took it too far. But yeah, like, anyway, that's in the script, though.
Yeah, like they said, Ric Flair was crying when he saw that. He didn't expect him to say that, or her to say that. So, man. But I feel like, you know what I'm saying, if they would have talked about it, you know what I'm saying, and told him, you know what I'm saying, it would have been cool. But if he ain't know about it, like what I heard, then that would be kind of messed up, but... Raw was decent. It was decent. I kind of feel like it could have been better, but it was decent though. Raw was decent.
Roman Reigns has already compiled a career's worth of highlights.
Well, you're right about that. Roman
was decent. Hey, who will ever forget? If you want to talk about NXT, I watch NXT, so I can remember. I can remember some matches. First kicked off, it was a match with Jason Jordan, and Gable and the Ascension. You know, when the Ascension came out, they got a big pop. They was held on SmackDown tonight too. The Ascension came out, they had a big pop. Like people missed them. But the match was decent, you know what I'm saying? NXT always takes it to the cake. NXT is basically one of the best indie wrestlers of wrestling. They got one of the best wrestlers. But yeah, it was a decent match. I was thinking that the Ascension was going to win because they came back. They didn't win. But they put up a good fight, though.
I'm starting to like the Ascension. To be honest,
they're decent. They stuck with Stardust, though. I don't know how that plays out. I don't get how that plays out.
I mean, I think that can work out for them, though.
just imagine how if the Ascension start to like dress like him and do all that weird stuff like that. Down after that.
That would be funny.
He's too good inside the ring to be out of the four for long. Oh my god, he messed up my sentence.
So what else happened on NXT?
I'm about to get to that. Like right now, I keep reversing. I'm trying to get to a part where I hit him down. I could go look at the back to the match card on YouTube. Hold up. Come on, Tyler Breeze. There you go. All right. Other than that, Alexis Bliss versus Bayley for the NXT champion. Great match. Obviously, you know, Alexis Bliss is the... I ain't gonna get into that anyway. Great match. Bayley no wins with the victory. I knew Alexis Bliss wasn't going to do it when, well, she did cut a good promo, but her promo seemed like she was hating on her. Like, it was like, oh, I'm this and I'm that, and Bayley, when you're going to realize these kids, I'm just take away the Bayley feel of it. It was a decent match. The match was kind of freaking long too, man. And that was the main event too. That was the main event match. That was the main event match at NXT. So
they're really trying to push divas these days.
Yeah, they're trying to, man. I don't blame them. Because a couple of months ago, divas was boring. Like when me and Frost say, the bathroom break. Before he imposes his will on an opponent. And then I don't remember this match at NXT. Hold on, it was Dash and Dawson versus Corey Hill, Corey Hollins, and John Stalker. Dash and Dawson won because they're pushing them. I don't see what's special about that tag team. Kind of the same exact tag team as I don't see what's special about with Alexa Bliss tag team with those two dudes. But whatever. But yeah, Cash, Dash, and Dawson. They trying to go for the tag team champions against the Von Villagers. Callisto versus Ryback. And matter of fact, last week NXT, they called out what's that crew called? What's that team called? Saw. What's the name of it? Freaking, what's the name of the tag team?
What?
Big Cass and
Enzo Amore.
Enzo Amore, yeah. They did a sneaking run and they injured them. And they're like, we're the new face of NXT. You know, trying to put their name up there like they this and that. Whatever. But other than that, that was basically NXT. NXT is basically an hour show. There's nothing really too much to it. No. Baron Corbin had a match. No, it wasn't a match. It was a little preview. But then Baron Corbin has a rivalry going on with Apollo Crews, so unleashing it for the second kind of a good match. Well, kind of a good rivalry. But Apollo Crews and then Baron Corbin, which is random for the NXT wrestler. I don't like him like that. But two finishing moves. First, the Carl Gotch inspired neutralizer, which is a cradle pile. And that was basically NXT, man. NXT. Yeah, that was NXT right there, man. Where he lifts his opponent by the
legs and spins him in the air. So how would you rate NXT?
Just from like that show?
Yeah, just that show.
Just the NXT?
Just that show.
If it's a 5-5 rating, I give it like 4-4. Could have been more like stuff doing to it. I think it was just like, you know, the matches. It was like really dull matches, but you barely see title matches like that on Monday Night Raw or SmackDown. That's why I rated it high, because it was a title match for the Women's Champion, NXT Champion. A Women's NXT Champion, basically. And, it was good. Especially watching Alexis Bliss. Yeah. That's a gift. Normally, and he goes for the pin. I'm sorry, bro. She's too fucking fine. And she knows she is, but she come out, you can see her face, like, you can see the face expression she's doing, like, she knows what she's doing, man.
Okay,
she's cocky.
We're gonna jump into SmackDown in a few minutes here. Let me just concentrate on this matchup.
This match is getting kind of confusing.
Superman Punch! Oh.
Come on.
Then we're gonna go for the spear.
Immeasurable in adjectives along those lines. Oh my god, he got a comeback. Oh no. I'm gonna get off this ring. Engine Gurry. Hit your comeback mode. Do it! Flip out the ring. I'm sorry, Dale, Tommy, leave me alone, man. I'm sorry. Chill, dog. Seems like these guys are letting out a lot of pent-up frustration tonight. Yes, I'm running away from Dale, Tommy. Filthy hands off me. Bam. He might reverse this, but if I'm taking this risk. Oh, okay, no, he didn't reverse the beauty shot. One, two, three. That's what I'm talking about, man. I'm about to download a new attire for Tyler Breeze. I'm tired of these pink type attire looking at this. Moves like that can upset your opponent more than hurt them. Somebody send me a phone request on
what
Facebook.
Up, Luis Martinez?
Luis Martinez, what's up, dog?
Welcome to the broadcast. You just missed us covering Raw and NXT. We're going to jump into SmackDown in a few minutes.
The body's taking some abuse here,
but nothing that can't be. But we're at a critical point of this matchup, so I don't want to jinx it by starting to talk about the next show. But while you're here, who do you think is going to win the tournament for the World Heavyweight Championship?
And oh yeah, I want to wait to see the description. I'll put it before I say anything. Ask another question. Oh my boy, Tyler Breeze, dog.
What an offensive show by Cesaro. Shoulders down, is it enough? This may be it.
Is it my eyes? When you look at me, Sami Zayn versus Finn Balor.
Oh, Roman Reigns! He saw that one coming. He's making a statement here with this attack. He's taking damage to the back of the head. That render most men.
Sami Zayn needs to come back.
Yes, he does.
Been a long time. No, speaking of Sami Zayn, it's a lot of Canada wrestlers in the WWE, man. Why? They got Tyler Breeze, Sami Zayn, freaking Chris Jericho, Edge, Christian, Kevin Owens. Who else?
Victor.
That was very popular.
Victor from the Ascension.
He's from Canada too?
Yeah.
There's the band. Got Lance Storm too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Lance Storm from the Canadian flag on entrance. Yes. It's a lot of them, man. No. Now, since we're talking about Canada, the promo with Zeb Coulter did on Kevin Owens' SmackDown was funny.
Uh-oh. I was just neutralized.
Uh-oh. Man, he came out there, he was like, you think your Canadians be smuggling our way? How do you make it to this country? Stupid, man.
Stupid, because he was doing that to Mexicans when he was with Jack Swagger. This far, it's been
so physical. How's that make it to this country, huh? This has been an make it to this country, war. And then you got Bertha Darrell co-signing. Now, Bertha Darrell, he looks like in perfect shape now, man. It looked like that time he took off, he went in the gym and he got built. Because before, he wasn't leaning like that. Oh, snap. Who's about this? He could pin his opponent right here. I think this is it. Oh my god. There we go. Bam. Bam. Oh. How did you miss that punch?
Spear out of nowhere. Here we see it one more time.
Yeah, I don't know if I can believe what I saw the first time. Oh, that reversed though. Here he goes for the win. Let's do this. Two. Three. Let me go to the SmackDown.
That's a match.
What else happened on SmackDown? That was good.
Okay, so SmackDown, there was Tyler Breeze versus Zack Ryder, where Tyler Breeze used the kill switch. I liked that.
I didn't even peep that. There was no love lost in that match, and look at the impact in these highlights.
That's pretty good. I believe that was one of the first matchups, too.
It was. First matchup was the Miz.
I can't believe what we're doing. Yeah, the Miz versus Cesaro.
Okay, he the comeback from fucking commercial break. He holding his jaw.
And he said he wasn't gonna wrestle.
It's the action. No, and that punch looked so real, man.
Oh, what a
it was zoomed
match.
In and everything. I'm reversing, bro. What the hell?
And speaking of the Miz, if you haven't seen Santa's Little Helper, you gotta see it if you like Christmas movies. I recommend it. I just watched that today.
No, a couple like an hour ago, to be honest. Happy 4th of July,
everybody. I sure hope Paige looks good in that movie.
She does. Oh my god, I can't reverse right now. I got no more slots. Where's my goal against this Sammy fucker, man? You keep killing me. Got you. And then after that, it was Adrian Neville and the Dudley versus Stardust and Ascension. I wasn't really into that match as much, but I believe Adrian Neville and Dudley Boys won.
Yeah, they did. They hit a 3D on, it was either Victor or Connor. I think it was Victor.
Because I was in my workout. I was watching that while I'm working out, so I didn't pay any attention to that match. Oh my god. No, you're not pinning me. Get off me. You don't grab me or kick me. I knew it. And after that, it was the Wyatt family came out and talked about the Undertaker and all this BS. And
the Undertaker, you know, did
a little
one of
promo.
Those promos live via satellite.
I don't know what, like, when was the last time Undertaker actually showed up on SmackDown? Years, right? It's been years now, right?
Yep. And SmackDown used to be his show.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Oh, snap, he got me. It's a rope break. Whoa, put the show on the first spin, dog. And then you had Charlotte versus Brie Bella. Charlotte was bleeding in that match. I saw her mouth and her hand. She had blood on her hand. It looked like she didn't want to like touch Brie Bella with it too. But the way I like she was holding her, like it seemed like she was gonna hold it by her palm, her hand. Oh yeah, they had a match. Charlotte went Super Saiyan on her. Oh man, he did the tornado DDT thing with me off. Quick.
Okay, so it's gonna be Bray Wyatt and Braun Strowman versus the Brothers of Destruction, which is what I predicted. And the Flavor Pack was all like, "Nah, no, no, Bray Wyatt's not gonna be in that match."
Bray Wyatt had to be in that match.
Exactly. I knew it was gonna be Braun Strowman because he's the strongest of the Wyatt family. He's a beast.
And he's new, you know. They gotta make him get some type of shine. Bam! Y'all already know what I'm about to do. Y'all know what I'm about to go for. The double kick off the rope. Where the hell did eight freaking Finn Balor's finish his call? Got him.
So Summer Rae under Divas or is she under managers? They should have made a manager Summer Rae too.
I think it's Divas. Oh, he kicked out! Oh my Lanta! I got one more finisher stored in me.
Because that's the next match I'm doing. Tyler Breeze versus Dolph Ziggler.
My boy Tyler Breeze, dog. Don't prove all y'all dudes wrong. I just really hope they don't put him as no jobber, man. Like an Adam freaking Rose. Which I feel like that's what they're gonna do, but I feel like he has that potential, dog.
Hey, Tyler
I don't
Breeze?
Think he would be. Yeah, I don't think he would be a WWE champion, but at least an Intercontinental United States. I'll be better if he's the Intercontinental champion.
I just want them to do but some. I heard Dolph Ziggler might be leaving soon.
I heard that too. But I don't. No, I forgot the review and read the news about John Cena taking break off. He's talking about some army, like he wants to something spend time with the military and arms and stuff like that. I read on Police Report. I like that. That was a good match. Finn Balor and Sami Zayn, you know what I'm saying? They had a good match. At the end of the match, they clapped hands and showed who's the winner.
I forgot to change for a ring. I forgot to change for ring. Whatever. I'm just going to quit out of this match and remake it.
We got 5 more minutes. Let me see. I'll probably do one more match. Sit back and mac. Think about it. That was SmackDown. That was it.
That was. SmackDown was really short.
And Roman Reigns and Ambrose, I didn't watch it, but I knew who won already. It's obvious. They always went on a freaking SmackDown all the freaking time. No start match.
I'm sorry, Gabrielle Rico, but I'm not taking suggestions for matchups. I'm kind of doing what I want to do. Hey, this time they made it Survivor Series automatically. That's cool. I didn't even have to change it this time. I don't think. I might have changed it, but I don't think I did.
I got good matches. Kevin Owens, Heath Slater. I might just do Seth Rollins versus Kane SmackDown. That's the match that's available right now. False count. Always in a false count. Freaking anywhere match, man.
Cena and the Luka Dragons versus Rollins and New Day.
I'm gonna do this match.
I'm sorry, Gabrielle Rico. I don't take suggestions.
He was on my stream, man.
He's
just
typing random matchups. I'm not taking suggestions. I'm just doing what I want to do, man. And while I'm doing this match, I'm gonna talk predictions. Roman Reigns versus Alberto Del Rio. Roman Reigns is gonna win. Invo, it should be a good match.
Punch and a spear.
It should be a good match.
Hopefully they have chemistry.
Match. And then Kevin Owens and Dean Ambrose. I think that's going to be the best match. Another amazing singles contest. These two never cease to entertain the WWE Universe. Never mind, because there still has to be Roman Reigns versus Dean Ambrose as an upper match. That's gonna be a really good match because they spend all their time together.
Yeah, they're best friends in real life too. Best friends in real life. But just imagine, if Roman Reigns, if Dean Ambrose wins, and Roman Reigns, though, he congratulates him. He just turns around and spears him. Turns heel. Oh my god.
Now, the best fight of the night is going to be Undertaker and Kane versus the Wyatt family.
Wait. Before I say anything, let's rewind. Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns. Look, this would be nice. Roman Reigns, right? Wins. Or it could be switched up. It doesn't matter. But Roman Reigns loses, man. And Dean Ambrose wins. He congratulates him.
And then Roman Reigns just loses it.
Spear.
And like, what if he just loses it? He's like, I've been waiting 3 months.
And then Sheamus comes out and cashes in and pins Dean Ambrose all of his legs.
Now, you know I want that to happen. Sheamus is my guy.
That will be it. And that will set up a rivalry between Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose. But it won't be for the championship, though. It will just be against them. Yes. But then that will be good. I like that. That will be beast. It doesn't really matter who. Like, if Roman Reigns could win and Dean Ambrose beats the hell out of Roman Reigns, and he just, and Sheamus comes out nowhere. Because Sheamus been quiet. Like, he's been a low key. And that's what they want. That's why they put him in a little tag team.
What about a future rivalry between Sheamus and Brock Lesnar, the Beast? We've seen plenty of fireworks
thus far tonight. I feel like Sheamus will lose.
He'll be feeling the effects of that. I just want to see that rivalry. I think that'd be good. Man, that looked bad.
You know, Paul Heyman gonna get in depth with his speech and talking ass. Making it
look easy. Because he'd be like, Brock Lesnar never got a fair match, or some shit like that. Like a fair rematch, and then he's gonna get a rematch against Sheamus.
No, speaking of Brock Lesnar, the only person, the last person he lost to was Triple H. He hasn't lost since. Who do you think? Do you think is gonna beat him? That would beat him. It can't be Roman Reigns because obviously that didn't work out of WrestleMania. They ain't wanting to do that. Becomes almost secondary when you get near. I don't know nobody. Nobody who can do it. Nicely done. Well, if I can be Dean, it ain't gonna be Seth Rollins. We've already been through that already.
What if a Wyatt family targets Brock Lesnar? My God, his
body's been through hell. That would be. They target him, but they're like, they okay. It's basically something similar to what happened with Jay and Shakira. Where is Jay? I'm gonna get back to though. Something similar that happened to Jay and Shakira and Kane and Seth Rollins. Remember how every week, like, they would lose one member. So you know what I'm saying? 4 weeks and wait, it's four of them. No, it's five of them, right?
My family, there's four.
Yeah, it's four, okay. So 4 weeks to build up, or it takes five, really. Bray Wyatt is the person who you know, he probably might fight at the pay-per-view, but, you know, like, as the build-up coming, like, Brock Lesnar, like, you know, he runs into each Wyatt family and he basically takes them out. And they be gone until the rivalry's over. So Bray Wyatt matches over, because that's what they did with Jay and Shakira and Kane when they went against Seth Rollins. Every week, Brock Lesnar would take out, like, he took out Kane, and he took out Jay, and he took out Jimmy, what the other nigga name is.
Okay, maybe, but
Jimmy.
I don't think Brock Lesnar can be dominant over the Wyatt family, because they got Braun Strowman.
And he,
like, what if Braun Strowman just comes in one time and tears Brock Lesnar apart? It sets up for a good match.
I just can't see him. I just can't see them making Brock Lesnar look weak like that. I can't see that happening. But you never know. You never fucking know. I think Kevin Owens and Brock Lesnar would be a good fucking match. It's an amazing match.
Oh, Dolph Ziggler put the sleeper hold on me.
I know Kevin Owens' fat ass gonna take it out to Suplex City, I know that. I know that already. Oh shit, it's 11:03. I'm gonna do this last match. Kevin Owens versus Heath Slater.
So as far as the Brothers of Destruction versus the Wyatt family, I almost think The Undertaker and Kane have to win. It's a must win for them.
But what if they don't? You don't think the rivalry's gonna continue? You don't think they're gonna disappear until... Well, Undertaker won't disappear, but Kane... What would Kane... That's what I'm saying! After this whole thing, what is Kane going to do? Because Kane has a contract, he always shows up on Raw and SmackDown. So, what is he just going to be a singles competitor? Because they washed him away from the Dory thing. They didn't want that to happen. When he lost to Seth Rollins, right, champions, they didn't have no promo about Kane and none of that. They just skipped right straight to the, you know, Undertaker and Kane shit. So I don't know what they would do with him.
You have to wonder what's going through these guys' minds in a match of this magnitude.
Like, you got to think about that.
Yeah.
I know after this, Taker's going to be gone for a couple of more months. Probably might not return to fucking Royal Rumble, or probably might not return until WrestleMania. To be honest, that's what I think I'll see him.
What a hellaciously physical match.
They don't have no, they don't got Randy Orton. Randy Orton is injured. You know what I'm saying? Rusev is injured. Like, they don't got nobody yet that can, like, really, you know what I'm saying, put a good rivalry to Undertaker. I would love to see a rivalry again against Undertaker and Randy Orton again. I think they had a good rivalry in the days. Like, the Legend Killer, like that.
So, Charlotte versus Paige. Paige is going to probably lose, most likely.
Yeah, of course, because Charlotte just won that champion. Night Champions, yep. Right? No, not that already. Probably a good match, though.
Then, as Clayton was saying earlier, Tyler Breeze is going to beat Dolph Ziggler.
I hope so.
With distraction from Summer Rae.
With Summer Rae, yeah, that's just going to happen. Distraction from Summer Rae.
And then, the 5-on-5 Survivor Series match, that's still up in the air. I think the New Day is going to participate in that. And we're probably going to have the Ascension on their team or something. And then the opposite team is going to have the Usos, the Dudleys, and Neville.
Neville, yeah. What the hell? That's probably what's gonna happen, yeah.
And that's for broadcast.
That's basically, we did everything. I mean, we didn't wanna, you know, make it too long. It's an hour. Just talk about everything. And we basically did that. We said everything in our opinions and some gameplay footage and an hour. I'm kind of going a little bit off hour because I'm in this last match right now.
I'm just a little bit under an hour, actually. So, subscribe. Leave a like if you enjoyed. You know, all the basic YouTube stuff.
Yeah, subscribe, like, leave a comment. Even if you hate it.
Also,
know what I'm saying?
You know, leave a dislike. Leave a dislike. I want a dislike, too.
At least it shows that somebody actually watched the video. Yep, I just won the match. Yeah, for more wrestling news, we're gonna be doing this. I'm doing this again on Sunday to talk about the review we're having on Sunday, and what I think is gonna happen on Monday Night Raw.
Anyway, so tune in after the pay per view on Sunday for the review show of the pay per view. And until next time, goodbye.
Yep. As y'all heard from him, same thing. Just tune in until right after Survivor Series Sunday, right after that. Like I said, I'm going to do a review. He's going to do a review. And I'm going to get my prediction what's going to happen on Monday Night Raw. And like basically what my boy Rayo said, just stay tuned. And leave a like, subscribe. Twitter, everything, Facebook is in the description of in this video, so if you want to contact me, if you want to message me and basically talk about, you know, what you think is going to happen and give me predictions, and I'll probably make